each other.
Well, not really. We live together. It's actual madness, willingly living with a wild animal, but one with thumbs who can steal your money and hurt you emotionally.
You're the Worst is a romantic comedy, as we know it, completely turned on its head. So the format of romantic comedies we've been brainwashed into thinking is right, boy meets girl and then walk off into the sunset. This is the antithesis of that.
It's sort of pitched as a romantic comedy with a twist, which is that the romantic comedy leads are really terrible, narcissistic, drug abusing, alcoholic.
So you have two very damaged people who find themselves somehow being perfect for each other in Jimmy and Gretchen.
Oh, stop. It's a soft case.
At the end of season two, Jimmy somehow admitted that he has fallen in love with Gretchen. Now, at the beginning of season three, he denies all knowledge that he ever said that, saying that he was blackout drunk. Classic Jimmy.
You said it!
I might also have said that I don't have an opinion on your pubic hair. Or that I was going to help Edgar with his resume. Doesn't make them true.
Gretchen and Jimmy have said, I love you, and now they are dealing with the ramifications of that. So we see Gretchen has come out of her depressive state. She's not necessarily doing it the right way, but she's going to therapy. She is attempting in her way to make herself a better person.
A psychiatrist is like, here, take these pills. A therapist is all, oh, tell me your I couldn't make it as an actor.
Lindsay has just finished making a verbal commitment to Paul that she's going to move forward in the marriage and have their child together. However, internally, she's having extreme reservations, and those two opposing feelings boil and come to a head.
Paul, this dress doesn't have a butt.
It's an apron.
My present is cooking?
Cooking as a family.
Family.
We kind of find Edgar on approaching the downward slope of what it's like to have PTSD, and now we're seeing that maybe the pills aren't working for him too well, and he's just kind of tired of it, wants to stand up for himself and keep moving forward in the best way that he knows how.
What is going on with you?
I got out of it, but they're still here. Plus, I have useful comedic skills and a Sharpie.
Sam and the boys are having a big secret reunion show tonight. You want to come?
Nope.
It's a really important night. Free booze.
I'll be there.
Seasons one and two, we shot Jimmy's house in an actual house, which is a beautiful house. Season three, they built Jimmy's house on a soundstage.
FX very kindly blindfolded us and led us into the stage and onto the set for the first time. That was like Christmas Day and seeing your presents.
No, you walk in and you're like, oh, we're blindfolded. Oh, I know. And then you take off the blindfold and it looks like the exact same freaking house.
Wow, this is crazy. Oh, dude, look how much bigger it is.
I was highly impressed with what we've got now.
My reaction when I first saw the set was, this is creepy, because it's so exactly like the house we used to shoot in, but 20% bigger.
We can remove the ceilings, we can remove the walls, which has opened up opportunities in terms of the shots that we can do. We've been far more creative this year.
I seriously think you may have a drinking problem.
I don't have a problem. Maybe you have a believing things drunk people say problem.
Chris Geere, most prepared actor I've ever worked with.
Working with Aya Cash has just been a bit of a career changer for me. She's set a bar so high, I love her for that.
I get sucked into how real she is that I'll find myself being like, oh shoot, I have to be in the scene now.
Entire cast is the most prepared and professional group of people that I've ever worked with, and they're always game to play.
I just wanted to say thank you for valuing my opinion.
I don't, never have. Worse than a dog's opinion.
I just love making this series because I get to work with my friends. I get to do interesting, smart stuff written by people who are much smarter and funnier than I am.
I think I've become more intelligent through playing him. Probably not.
So you might just suddenly bounce.
Any minute.
I love you.
Jimmy.